After the Pulwama attack, tensions have been high between India and Pakistan. It is high time we answered the inevitable question. What would happen if India went to war with Pakistan? Well, historically, the Pakistani army has faced shameful defeats at the hands of the Indian army in 1965, 1971, 99, etc. The Indian army is sizably more powerful, has better ammunition and aircrafts, better training, and in all fronts is much better than the Pakistani army. But are things different now? One important factor which differentiates any future war from the wars which we fought against Pakistan in the past is the fact that China has now become a major ally of Pakistan. Chinese investments in Pakistan has been on the rise, Chinese debts are on the rise, and in short, Pakistan is willing to do anything and everything to please China. The Chinese army is independently quite powerful and it's much larger than the Indian army. And now adding Pakistan to the equation would certainly give them an upper hand. Now, if America or Russia were to support India, it would obviously be an advantage for us and indeed make us more powerful. But let us be a little practical. Both America and Russia, although friendly countries, are not very reliable in war times, especially considering the fact that no one wants to mess with China if they are not going to gain out of it. Now, for a second, let us both assume that America and Russia remain mute spectators. Well, this is where Prime Minister Narendra Modi's foreign trips have helped India in a massive manner. Ever since Modi came to power in 2014, his foreign trips have been a huge point of criticism. But what we must observe is that most of these foreign trips were strategically planned. To understand what I mean, you need to look at the map of China. Starting from the northwest, we have Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, Mongolia, Japan, South Korea, Taiwan, Philippines, Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, Myanmar, Bhutan, and Nepal bordering China from different directions apart from India. Our Prime Minister has had diplomatic discussions in Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan, and Mongolia in 2015. Laos in 2016, Philippines and Myanmar in 2017, Kazakhstan, Japan, South Korea, Vietnam, Cambodia multiple times, and of course, Nepal has been a strategic partner of India for quite long. Diplomats from these countries too have visited India multiple times. What we need to understand is that all these countries have a share of their own problems with China, and none of them look at China as an ally. Post these visits, ties have been strong with these countries, and a few of them have even had military cooperation ties. Now, think of two scenarios, one where India is independently fighting Pakistan and China, and a second scenario where China is being attacked from all directions and they are trying to defend their own land, effectively rendering Pakistan's so-called friendship with China completely useless. You may hate or love Narendra Modi for his politics in India, but at an international level, his diplomacy and strategic thinking is simply outstanding. Bear in mind that this is not rocket science. Anyone who sees the map of China and understands basic international politics will be able to figure it out. But it was only Narendra Modi who had the vision to unite all these countries for the safety and security of India.